So I am working on harmonizing the conceptualization of observation parameters. I would like to introduce me a little bit. I'm a semantic analyst and data manager at the Environmental Agency of Austria. And I had been co-developing Seronto. This is a social ecological research and observation ontology in 2009 until 2011. This ontology has not been used so much because we had no money left to continue the research on that. But we continued to work on vocabularies and we developed ENFTES, which was based on the Seronto findings, and I'm the coordinator of ENFTES, and ENFTES is a vocabulary used by a research infrastructure called long-term ecosystem research, and there's international, the ILTER and the ELTER Europe, and I'm coordinating it for Europe. There's also the worldwide ELTER, so ILTER, the ILTER is the international one, the worldwide. Okay, in the US they are using another vocabulary which is compatible to ENFTES. So we helped each other, and we are in the ongoing months, we are going to extend each other's vocabulary, so this will be very compatible for researchers working with different data sets. Now I am involved in ENVRIPLUS. ENVRIPLUS is a project dealing with a lot of different research infrastructures, environmental research infrastructures, and I'm involved in the data theme, where I also developed a reference model with other researchers for ENVRIPLUS, and I'm also coordinating the provenance task there. And ENVRIPLUS is now will terminate in April next year, but it will be followed up by ENVRIFAIR, so another 4 years of project going as a building on the research done so far. I'm also involved in the RDIA, that's Research Data Alliance, which is an international community. Targeting to enable open sharing and reuse of data, and there I'm also involved in. So I'm involved in the VSIC, that's the Vocabulary and Semantic Service Interest Group led by Simon Cox and others, and this VSIC interest group is organized in different task groups, and one of these task groups started this at the beginning of this year, and I was interested to bring together different people with the same objective, which is the harmonization of measurement parameters. And I do this leading together with Michael Diepenbrock, which is working in Pangaea. So this is a rather large group of stakeholders involved. So we have different research infrastructure representatives. So long-term ecosystem research, that's me, Alessandro Ogioni and Philippe Tambev. Then we have the ILTER from the ILTER network, Christian Vanderbilt. And I'm invited in October to speak also in California at their sorry, I made an error. It is not ILTER, it is US ELTER. It's the US long-term ecosystem research network there. And I'm invited to talk to them to harmonize these different approaches also with them. Then ICOS is involved, ANARE, LifeWatch, AquaDiva. These are all different research infrastructures dealing with different domains in the environmental research. And lots of people who are also partly involved in Embry Plus, others not, like those from AquaDiva. And we are also working together with data centers like Pangaea, which is led by Michael Diepenberg, with BODC, CDataNet, with Alexander Kokinaki, probably you know her, GF Bio, Naol Karam, so different data centers. And we are also working together with different representatives of technologies, ontologies, so BioPortal, John Grayville, and Envo. So Pierluigi Putilek is also interested to join this effort, and Chris Mangel, and also EPIC with Ulrich Schwartmann, and also with Markus Stocker. I'm not sure if he has joined us. Do you see if he's there?
I don't think he's joined, Barbara, but Simon Cox has. He's joining us. And just to point out to other people, John Grabeel has presented in this forum before, and what we see here is quite a small community, I think, because I and certainly Simon and you, Barbara, know quite a few of the people that are listed on this slide here. So this community of ours of vocabulary work and so on is not enormous. At least environmental vocabulary is not enormous.
No, but for that we started this year to work together, I think it's a good starting point. Yeah. So, and we are interested to enlarge this group and also to invite you to join this effort or to see how we can learn from each other. So, but for me, it was really interesting to see that the interest grows on it, because it seems that there are lots of approaches, but not everything is solved yet. So that's what we found out so far. So what we intend to do in this task group is to develop best practices and generally accepted model for scientific observation and measurement parameters, including also, if possible, measurement methods and devices by using agreed core terminologies. So this because we want to annotate research data with these vocabularies and at the end be able to improve interoperability for data discovery and data integration. So the challenge is we want to analyze ecological phenomena across geographic, temporal, biological scales. And this requires a variety of existing data sets, which might derive from different data centers. So we are dealing with observational data, which is often represented in tabular form. This data differs in a number of attributes and relationships implied between the attributes and the coding conventions used for representing information within data sets. So that's not that trivial as it might seem in the beginning, because although there are already a lot of different schemas trying to solve this issue, these schemas are different, very different in scale, and are incompatible to each other. They capture the data semantics in different complexity. So they describe the complexity in different ways, and sometimes they say at a very rough level. They provide semantics for specific domains, and for each domain there are different approaches. that indicate the admitted value of attributes, sometimes very vaguely, and they account or not for the specification of units. So most schemas capture insufficiently data semantics by conflating associated attributes and thus are not suitable to correctly describe unambiguously complex parameters. And I will show it only on a few parameters here or on a few examples. So this is how we always have to deal with, also we have to deal with observational data. They come along as a tabular information with columns indicating different attributes. It's not always sure what the abbreviation means, or researchers have very often to deal to interpret and to compare and try to find out what is really meant. Sorry, I'm at home and I have a dog, and sometimes he barks. And I'm sorry about that. So it is not always easy to understand what is meant by the different columns. But to come to the point, what we mean with conceptualization is that there's a property, a monitored property, which could be described in a sentence like monthly mean dissolved lead in parts per billion in water taken from the River Thames by sampling. Yeah, and so using the O&M nomenclature, we would say that we could differentiate between a feature, an observable property, and the process. And in this case, the feature, so the object in nature which has a location, would be x and y coordinates, would be the River Thames. The observable property, the monthly mean dissolved lead in water, and the process would be sampling by sampling. And this could be then more specified. But the issue which makes it more difficult is to try to decompose the middle element here, the observable property, in atomic elements. So, for example, we could say what is monthly mean here, what is dissolved lead concentration, the BPP water. So, how can we call them, and what are these elements? We can see that this is dealt very differently in the different approaches. For example, in Seronto Core, which I was developing with my LTR team, is not going into detail what is really, as when we talk about this atomization. So what we have here is that we have in the middle the value set, which is the observation more or less, and which has an investigation object we are observing, and the parameter method is a complex element which has a parameter and has a method, but how this parameter itself is composed here, it is not clear. Yeah, it lets it open. And if you look at Oboe, for example, then which is used by Aquadiva and by ANAE, we can find out that the model identifies entities or objects being observed, and the observation of entities and their corresponding measurements. And for each measurement, there is the value of a characteristic of the entity according to a measurement standard or a protocol and the context assumed by each measurement and observation. But it is not really clear how this characteristic should be, what it is about, yeah, this characteristic. And I make this a bit more clear at the example, trying to describe this example tree, diameter at rest height. And you could say that the observation has an entity, in this case, tree, and the measurement on that tree would be using the element characteristic, which is the diameter at breast height, and this measurement has then a value and uses a standard. But we could also say, nobody would hinder us using OBOE, that the characteristic in this case is diameter, and the protocol would be measured at breast height. So there, it's up to the researcher then to decide how he describes it within OBOE. Yeah, and we can see that in the different research infrastructures as we have in our group, ANAE and AquaDiva, that they use it differently. Yeah. Then, so if we then try to describe more complex parameters like concentration of nitrate in soil water, we find that OBOE is limited because the characteristic in that case is the nitrate concentration. So you have then to bring together two concepts or two elements together in one concept. But you could also say that it might be important to differentiate between concentration and nitrate. So it's just to make this clear. And also soil water, which is the entity, could be split in soil and water. Yeah, because you are observing the nitrate concentration in the water of the matrix soil. And this is not depicted here. And if you look at the observation measurements of Simon Cox, then you see that we talk here about observed properties, about the phenomenon, but we are not going into detail what this phenomenon could be. But there are extensions of this. And I will go soon explaining this, but I just wanted to compare O&M and OBOE, and this is more or less rather simple to compare. There could be some I think they are rather clear how they could be compared, and that I tried it here. But still, when it comes to properties, they both don't have a real good solution, because when I come across the lead pattern and Fodden, they use an extension of OnM and say that the observable property, the phenomenon types could be better described if they are split into different other concepts like object of interest and property, but also matrix and statistical measures and so on. So they go for the approach to atomize this observable property and different other elements. And in ENFDES, I try to follow this scheme and say, okay, if we are looking at the concentration of sulfur in soil water, We can atomize this description in different elements and say concentration would be the property, sulfate would be the object of interest, the per unit volume unit, and soil water would be the matrix, and lysimeta the device, for example. And in ENFDES, we have also the compound concept used by the scientists, which would be then the parameter. The parameter is then a compound description of what could be then split in different elements, atomic concepts. So you would find both levels of descriptions. And for simplicity reasons, we would not have concentration of sulfate in soil water, but only concentration of sulfate, which is not, I'm not sure if this is the best way to do it, because it's always a compromise between what is used by the scientist and what would be sensible to use for consistency reasons. So probably, so ENFDES is not finished. So this this thesaurus is in continuous evolvement, and it should also be like that. And probably we will come up with different solutions. So that we could have concentration of sulfate, and then as a parent, and then differentiated where this concentration of sulfate could be, to have other parameter specifications. Yeah, but this is not really decided. But the status is that we have concentration of sulfate as a parameter. And so if you are interested to know more about ENFDES, we can also talk about that afterwards, because I am more expert, so I can more explain you better on ENFDES and on the other models here presented here. So then in Pangaea, they also try to describe the different parameters depending on their complexity. And there are some approaches proposed by Robert Huber, but it is not fixed yet, because they are Pangaea, as Michael Diepenbrück really looks for solutions which are then accepted not only for Pangaea, for Germany, but they want to use data from the whole Europe and other parts of the world, and then try to really find a common approach or a mappable approach. So they are still open to change this according to the outcome of this group. So this is all in discussion. And BODC, this is also a data center in France, which deals with C-DataNet, with C-data information. And they seem also to follow this approach of atomizing complex properties. And they have also a composer for this for the description of parameters, and to compose this description they use for each of these elements vocabularies. So for example, for the measurement or the property, they have the vocabulary as six, which are for example temperature, uptake rate, abundance, concentration, or the entity or object could be a biological entity or chemical entity or physical quantity, and for each of them they have specific vocabularies they use. or they have the environmental matrix or compartment, or the measurement matrix relationship, which is helping to compose the sentence of the observation. So it seems, but I'm not sure, or I'm sure that we will find some inconsistencies also there with the approach I presented before, but it seems that it goes in this direction, in the same direction. So what we did so far, we had 6 meetings where each of us did presented our approach. Also some of us, yeah, the LTR, Aquadiva, Pangaea, BODC, ANA, and ENVO, yeah. And we found out that we need to go into much more detail and really look for describing complex use cases with our own approaches, then analyze the real differences between the different approaches, and then find out where is the gap. Is there a possibility to map it so that it is unambiguous? Can we then find a common approach? What can we do? And this is not done just by presenting each other's approach. This is done by doing a really working group out of it. So we decided to prepare a case statement to become a working group, and this will then start in this autumn. So I cannot present here some news in that sense that we have invented already a new approach, but there is a big intention to go in this direction. This is not the roadmap because it has not been agreed so far, but it's some ideas. So we want to agree on core terms so that we, if I say property, everybody in the group understand what I mean by property. That's not so sure because everybody has another connotation to this term. So we have to find our own language. Yeah, whatever then at the end stands there. For a specific concept, for me it doesn't matter which name we use then. We have to agree on terminologies, on already existing terminologies, yeah, for core elements, for example, for chemical elements, the JV or whatever, yeah. Then choose good use cases with different complexity degrees, yeah. Try to describe these specific use cases with each other's approaches we have in our communities, and then compare them. And find out the gaps, differences, and whatever, come to a conclusion where we overlap, and out of that, develop a common model or mapping scheme between all of these different approaches, and then produce guidelines, write publications, and so on. But for doing this, yeah, we need also some money, a project behind, and we are working hardly on getting some funding for this work. But I'm optimistic. I'm sure we will find a way to work on this because we really need to go onward this. So for sure, we are looking to involve other important stakeholders. Yeah, and we. I will also try to bring together the people after the long summer period again in autumn. Yeah, and I invite also you to join us. So that's what I wanted to tell you. So if you have any question, please just go ahead. Thank you.